Mosquito, latest British-built light bomber, prominently figured in the day raid of the Philips radio works in Holland. Crews of the 100 aircraft engaged had been well schooled in the objects of the mass attack, which was planned long ahead. It remained only to go there and do the job. The Mosquito is an outstanding aircraft which has already distinguished itself in daylight raiding, but this was the first time it had been filmed in an operational flight. Two fine U.S. types were represented in the attack. First, the Ventura, latest development of the Lockheed Hudson, appreciably faster than its predecessors. The other American planes were the famous Bostons, which we shall see in a few seconds. The objective being a specified factory on which direct hits alone would be worthwhile, the raiders employed their now familiar technique of bombing in broad daylight from low level. The course set took the aircraft in a straight line over the channel on towards their industrial objective, only a short flying time distant. Now we see the Bostons, and in these pictures sense the speed as the formations almost skim over the water. Low coast of Holland, only 60 miles from the factory, as yet no opposition, nor will there be any signs of people. The raid was on Sunday, and it's dangerous for the Dutch to cheer as our planes go over. The Philips factory, biggest radio works on the continent, now working for the Nazis making radio location. The aircraft fire at gunners on the roof. This is government film, unfortunately damaged during development, but even in this state it conveys a graphic idea of the intense attack. Pictures show the factory ablaze at many points, much of it completely destroyed, much so badly damaged it would be many months before it's in production again. Of the 100 bombers that went into attack, 12 did not return. Black and fighter planes put up a strong resistance, but not enough to protect the important target. Reported direct hits. Low-level attackers see what they bomb. They have none of the uncertainty of the sub-stratosphere radar or the night bomber. One or two planes bore the scars of war. One made a pancake landing, its undercarriage mechanism being badly shot up. All round, this raid was one of the RAF's finest achievements.